Welcome to the Pixelberry Choices Podcast. I'm your host, Nirban Day. And today we're going to be talking about a very interesting thing, the choices, love interest combination or format. Recently, a lot of books people are playing and they're kind of unhappy about how the allies are. Maybe some are saying there's not enough time with a particular ally, or maybe there is not a proper distribution, even distribution between male, female ally, or one dominating ally or another ally. So I just want to talk about this. And again, this is an opinion video, so make sure whatever I say here is just my opinion. Voice your opinion below in the comment section, and we'll talk there. All right. So books like Laws of Attraction, where before chapter 9, a lot of you said, and I also saw that Gabe was kind of pushed. Even the wedding scene, we go with Gabe. Even they give Gabe to sit beside us and stuff. So I get that Gabe has a story arc. Gabe selects us for the spot and so on. Same goes with Ethan in Open Heart and some other books. Now, we can't do much about that because that's how they have designed the story. But still, I think there are some things that choices can do. So, whenever we see this kind of unprecedented thing, we go to precedent. So, what is the precedent? The precedent is High School Story. The precedent is America's Most Eligible, Endless Summer, and the old books. So, we see there, for instance, Endless Summer, we have Jake, Sean, Queen, and Estella. So four love interests, equal division, all have same time. And same goes for America's Most Eligible. We have equal ally time. High School Story, equal ally time. So I think what should be done, throughout the first 6 or 7 chapters, we should be given equal time with all the allies, irrespective of what they are. It doesn't matter if they're our boss, they did that, they're our head, but if they are an actual ally, they're introduced, then we should be given proper time to get to know their backstories, or maybe a little subtle, you know, intimate moments, or what we're having with Gabe, like kind of getting closer then pulling back. We should have all those things where we will get to know that person throughout this build-up will happen. And then, boom, chapter 7 or 8, we'll be given a choice. For instance, we're at a party or somewhere, so we get to choose one person out of 4. Then we'll go from there throughout the book. Then we'll get another option to choose. So I think that's what choices are missing. Because I played Foreign Affairs. There were 3 allies. But I don't think I got to know much of them that deeply. They sort of said, okay, choose your scandalous for love interest. Then they said, all right, this is your love interest. Then at one point, I thought it's locked. But after chapter 8, again, it opened up. But truly, the knowing of a love interest, because I remember playing High School Story, I got to know Michael's story, Emma's story, Maria's story. I got to know Caleb's story, Aiden's story. I got to know all of their stories for so long. And then at the end, we had the choice. So I think that's what we need to do. It's not like when we're getting to know their story, they say, okay, this is a 30 diamond scene. You get to know their story. You get to solve their problems. And you have a really intimate moment. We don't want that. First, give us subtle moments, some, you know, just spend time, know the background, and then give us an option. Like, if there are 5 allies, give an option who to choose, who to make your this, that, and then from there we'll go. That's how it was in all those books, and that's how I think it should be. And I don't think allies should be pushed. I know there could be, you know, one is our boss or our superior, the other one maybe is our colleague. But, you know, there is an equal storyline, and I'm not saying that if we romance someone else, that doesn't mean the other allies, we don't get to know about them or their story. Of course, we'll get to know their story. Of course, we'll get to solve their problems, but not maybe as allies, but as friends. We do that in High School Story. We do that in America's Most Eligible. We're not dating Adam McKenzie if we choose Jane in book 2 and book 3. But still, we are solving their problems. So getting to know their story arc. So there to spend diamonds for them. But doesn't necessarily mean that we'll be spending time with them as a love interest. I think that thing, it went wrong with Open Heart at the end. You know, still, you know, some chapters of Laws of Attraction, Foreign Affairs. So I think choices do need to look back into these things, because they had really good love interest model, like two male, two female, or like that. Like in America's Most Legible also, you know, Adam, then Derek, Mackenzie, Jen, like this equal division we used to have back in the days that we don't have now, and it really sucks. High School Story, you see, we had Emma, this Maria, and then Mackenzie, Caleb, Aden, Michael. So these, you know, and also this background story they told us. It was not all go from book one, but getting to know them first. I think that's what we're missing, getting to know them first. But by the way, gotta give credit where it's due. Laws of Attraction does a pretty good job, but only with Gabe and not also 100%. We don't still get to know 100% Gabe. They're just coming closer to us like a forbidden romance, and they're just pulling back, coming closer, pulling back. So I think we gotta get to know the stories like we did back in the days with America's Most Eligible, High School Story, Endless Summer, and some other books that I don't remember pretty much. Big Sky Country, great book, Big Sky Country. So that's a part of the discussion, and that's my opinion on it. Let me know what you think in the comment section below, and yeah, let's see how next books are going to be affected and what happens next. So comment below, talk to you there. Till next video, see you in another video. All right, bye guys, stay safe, peace out.